like I'm stuck in a trance, and I better take advantage. Who knows when I get another chance? Yeah. I feel like breaking two, electric boogaloo. You play Kelly, I be ozone, Travi, Laz, and Tyo Cruz. Now I know how to get down on the floor.
Alright, and welcome back to Oceanic Gang's Aegis Allegiance Gauntlet. We have for you today Team Chap vs Team EGR. So, this is the fourth game in the series, correct me if I'm wrong, with... Oh, hang on, it must be the third game in the series, sorry guys. Third game in the series. We've got 2-1 in favor of Team VGR. I should later be joined by my co-caster OCG Irate Pirate, and we'll be getting into it shortly. So, we're already straight into the pick and ban phase. The bans are pretty rapid fire at this point. The third game into the series, these players know one another. They're pretty experienced in what they find comfortable and familiar and what they're good at, so they should be banned out. So I'm surprised that we're not seeing a Lee Sin or a Nekton ban coming out from Team Chao, the blue team. Just because I Am Adept has proved to be very superior on those two champions, and almost game-changingly so. So the strategy might be to take one of those heroes away from him, or maybe to let him have it and then found some other counter. But it's been the first game so far in this series that one or the other hasn't been banned out. So that's always interesting to know. And we've actually had Jarvan locked in for the blue team. So Jarvan's an interesting hero that can be played in multiple lanes. He can be played top, mid, in the jungle, or in a kill lane in the bot lane. So truly a fantastic champion to pick first.
And not like a very outrageous pick.
No. Sounds like we've got you back as well. Welcome back, man. How are you going?
Oh, not bad. Just making sure that my LAN is all going well and all the other things, you know?
So, I like it.
It's a busy life, cooking dinner.
I haven't got around to doing that for myself yet. Alright, so Vi has been locked in, and most likely we'll see Janna locked in as well. Volpe has been playing Janna pretty much the entire tournament, really, so no corkballs being thrown here. It's been pretty good as well. Nice disengage, tornado knockup, shield to mitigate damage, and that global passive is just amazing. Tailwind adding move speed to every single member of your team is always nice. And it is locked in.
Locked in.
Alright, so next picks for Team Chao. They've had a trend of picking their solo laners quite early. So I wouldn't be surprised to see that happen again. It looks like they're picking their AD carry and maybe even their support now, though.
Yeah, ooh, an Ashe.
Ashe?
Chucking arrows from everywhere.
Wow. I think Ashe Zyra is probably one of the strongest lanes at the moment. So much peel, so much disengage, but so much initiate with that enchanted arrow.
Enchanted Crystal Arrow into Zyra's Snare into Ice Arrows is just...
the pain.
Very annoying. Yeah. Interesting to see the Evelynn ban.
Yeah. Considering that we weren't too impressed with it, it's maybe the players are feeling the pressure much more from that invisible ganking jungler, so...
Yeah. Maybe so.
Maybe so. So, we are seeing... Wow, it's actually a lane... Nincompoop has been subbed out for NZ Stealth. That's quite interesting, I didn't notice that until now. So NZ Stealth...
I was gonna make a comment about that, but then I thought maybe he's been here the whole time and I just haven't been paying attention.
No, definitely not. Stealth has been playing a lot of AD carry on the Oceanic server, transitioning to jungling from the NA server.
Yeah, no, because NZ Stealth was always well known as a very effective jungler.
But his AD carry is fairly terrifying, if we're being honest. So it's going to be cool to see it.
Definitely. And we actually see the Renekton being picked up by Chao.
Yep, that takes it away from Adempt. But I'm pretty sure we're going to be seeing...
Adempt isn't in the game.
Oh my god. Right, so Insane Pain. This is quite a lane swap, actually.
This is quite a series of subs.
Yeah, well, these were all listed subs under... the page, just let me double check before I'm speaking nonsense. Nope, they're all registered players, so this is absolutely okay. They are going through the 7 players on their roster. A little bit confusing for Team Chao, but hopefully they can come back and get on top of it.
Yeah, and you're getting in people who just aren't warmed up, who haven't been playing with the team for the day, so it's going to be interesting to see whether this hinders them significantly.
Yeah, or if it benefits them on the other side of it. Because it is a fresh player that hasn't been playing for the past, 5 or 6 hours. So yeah.
That definitely is a consideration. And we see a Karthus softlock.
Yeah, I wouldn't be surprised if we did see the double global ultimates coming down. Arkale, very well known for his Karthus. He runs a utility Karthus half the time, which is very strange to see, like a high move speed Karthus. But it definitely works out for him.
Yeah, the ability to get yourself where you need to be right in the center of that fight is quite important.
Yeah. So 25 seconds he has left before he locks in that pick or decides to go back to something else. And then we'll see what we shall see.
We shall see what we shall see.
And it does look like it's going to be Karthus locked in. I can't imagine him picking anything else. Orianna's quite a tricky champion to lane against. Very, very aggressive. The ball offers a lot of harass, and she's quite good at getting away from ganks with her shield and her speed up. So, good champion in the lane, and that has been locked in. So, seeing double global ultimates coming out from Team VGR. There's also the global passive coming out from Janna, and I like it. So it looks like Insane Pain is actually going to be in the top lane, and we're going to have Enter Stealth on the AD carry, and everyone else is where they normally are, so that makes sense. So Tristana and Nami, first time we've seen Nami in this series, for the bot lane for Team Chao, and that's pretty cool as well. And you've got the wombo combo of the Orianna Jarvan or the Orianna Renekton doing the bold delivery service.
And then, you drop your Cataclysm, you drop your Command Shockwave, and you drop your Tidal Wave. And that's quite a lot of CC, that's quite a lot of, disruption in the middle of a fight.
Yeah, I see.
Caitlyn does have a net to get out of that Cataclysm. But nowhere near as mobile as an EZ.
Or a Tristana, for that matter.
Yeah, but at the same time, you've got Vi on Wobbles, with the ability to just, click that Tristana, and then boom, shooting straight at her, which can also be a disadvantage if you're going hard onto the ADC and suddenly the ADC rocket jumps, flashes behind the second turret, and you're the Seeker missile zooming in on them, and suddenly you're massively away from your team, you're too deep, and you just get blown up.
Yeah, most definitely. So I'm liking both these lineups. I feel like the globals that's always just so intimidating. Knowing that the Karthus Requiem and that Shen Stand United is on the map just worries people in lane. Because at any stage in the game, the person that you are killing is going to have this giant shield, and all of a sudden that giant death beam is going to be locked onto your head. And it's always trouble. It's always trouble.
Yeah, it really just changes the way in which you evaluate when you engage and when you just need to run and recall, because if you're genuinely sitting there and you're like, oh, I'm feeling pretty strong, we can take them in a 2v2, you're suddenly going to be thinking, oh, is Shen ult up? Is Requiem up? This probably isn't going to be a 2v2. Even if we kill them, we need to be getting out with a good whack of health, or it's bye-bye.
Yeah. Nope, I agree with you there. And we've got Karthus taking Teleport, so a little bit more global than he normally would be, and we've got Nami on Team Chao taking Ignite. So that should be interesting for the bot lane. I'm very surprised, actually, because you can exhaust a lot of the members of VGR quite successfully and really mitigate their damage. But it looks like they're actually planning to play aggressive in this bot lane against Caitlyn and against Janna. So I wonder how that's going to work out for them. Maybe Mukikao is some god hand at landing bubbles, and if so, then the Ignite's really going to work out for him.
Yeah, and there's no cleanse on the Caitlyn, so bubbles are bad news.
Yeah, they are. And considering that if you're really, really good with bubbles, you can probably break 90 caliber net with them. So,
yeah,
depending on how you time them.
Pick them up mid-net.
Yeah, man, it's going to hurt.
Hurt very badly.
So yeah, this is game 4 of the series. That's what I was trying to get at before. Already had 3 games, and we have the possibility for 2 more. If VGR take this one, They are going to win the series and win these grand finals. However, if Team Chao win this one, we're going to take it to Game 5. So a lot of
that'll be really exciting
for both teams. I mean, if you're either going to win this game or be knocked out, and both would make you, you know, light a fire under you, make you play your best, get you inspired, get you motivated, and all that kind of good stuff. So I'm hoping we see, you know, a special game coming up for both these teams.
Do we know how the playoff for third has gone?
I can check, but I do not know personally. But that is going on in parallel while we're doing this.
Is that also a best of five, or is that a best of three?
That is probably a best of three.
So that should be done by now.
Yes, sir. All right, and we are into the loading screen. We're running... Oh my god, that's a lot of skins. Team Chao running 5 skins again. Props to those guys. But Insane Pain and Vault Support letting us down, man. What, 8 out of 10 skins. I would have wanted, you know, a clean sweep, but... C'est la vie.
Yeah, well, I don't know. The Shen skins are reasonably lackluster.
I didn't just hear you say that.
Well, like, what Shen skins do you like?
I like the Blood Moon Shen. Let me look it up for you. It's the red one.
The red one. Exactly. That's the biggest thing you have to say about the Shen skin. It's the red one.
Well, it matches the
Akali. That doesn't excite
one.
Me. Right. Doesn't excite me.
How on earth do I copy this? Maybe I'll just take a screenshot of it for you.
But,
alright, I just pasted it into chat. Go check it out.
But you know that Wolf is just running normal Janna, not because he doesn't have any skins, but because that's just what he wants to run.
Yeah. Because
he's definitely got Victorious.
Yep. But Frost Queen Janna is actually the best. And they recently released news about Forecaster Janna, the legendary skin for Janna. And that looks
good.
Yeah, cool as well.
The one where she's like a new person.
Yes, yes, she is indeed.
But, no, I didn't even realize I had, didn't even realize I had Victorious Janna for a long time, till somebody asked me why I wasn't using the skin. I was like, what skin? Like, Victorious Janna skin, and I was like, what is a Victorious Janna skin?
Well, you know that you can get the Judgment Kale one as well, you probably have that. You know about
how?
That?
30 seconds. No?
You got that for playing, like, X amount of ranked games, and I'm sure you have that as well. And then you can get a free Unchained Alistar skin, if you like, if you subscribe to Riot Games
I've
YouTube.
I've got Unchained Alistar, I've never used it though.
Yep, and you know about Riot Girl Tristana for liking their Facebook page?
Oh yeah, I got that so long ago. And I've also got Victorious J4 as well.
Nice, pimpin'.
But, because that was Season 1, right?
I think so, yes.
Minions have spawned. Yeah.
So I've got all the season rewards, but never use them.
Yeah, Victorious Elise is going to be the next one. And I know a lot of people are really keen for that. The thing I'm keen for, though, is they're doing Victorious Wards. So if you are gold and above, you'll get the new ward skins. And I think that's such a cool idea.
Yeah, so the other ward skins, like the Halloween ones, were just limited time affairs, weren't they?
Yeah, they were. I bought something like... Mine ran out 3 weeks ago, so that's how many I have.
So do you only get a certain amount of them?
Yeah, you bought them for a week. Or a day or whatever, so like... You spent like 100 IP for a week or whatever it was. So yeah, they were just limited time. I wish I could have bought them like forever, because the Deadfall ones were so cool. But yeah. That's not Riot's game plan at the moment. I'm hoping there's like a championship one when World Champs starts up. We'll see.
Yeah, that'd be cool. But I just really don't pay enough attention to the limited edition stuff. Which, there's so many icons and stuff that I've missed out on just because I can't be bothered.
Oh, that's alright. Like, none of the things you can buy in League of Legends really change the game. Other than, like, the aesthetics. And that isn't truly important. So you can say you're a purist or something, I believe you.
Yeah, well, I guess it's just like I didn't really care back in the day, but now I'm coming around to the fact I kind of do. I wish I had bothered, you know, getting all the various limited time skins.
Yeah. Are there some that you really want?
Well, there's just some, like, Earth Warwick, where I was just like, nah, I don't care. And then, like, the Winter Games stuff, and there's just been so many of them that I just haven't bothered to pick up.
Yeah, I see. I wish I got Championship Riven, man. I didn't realize it was limited edition. I don't even really play Riven, but now it goes for, like, $800 on eBay.
Yeah, exactly. It's just like watching the top 10, you know, rarest skins, and it's just like, I could have bought all those. I was around for that. But let's talk about the games, and I think really much has happened, so you haven't really missed much with us talking about skins.
Yeah.
And wards and such, but just, you know, junglers coming through, we actually see Vi sitting at top, looking like she's looking to make a play. Wobble's trying to get in there and make some effect early. The connection's quite deep. I wonder what she's waiting for.
I'm not sure. Maybe for him to use Slice and Dice, because it's only easy use that she knows she can successfully gank him. She juked the Vault Breaker, however, got both charges of Slice and Dice off, and unfortunately that was a unsuccessful gank for Wobbles.
Real rough, and that's always so gutting. You sit there, you wait for what you think. Oh, here we go again! Gets the red buff off. Very nice taunt, the Vault Breaker goes off, and the Ignite, and that's first blood. Lovely flash, flash smash to get the first blood to secure it.
Nice. I've just been told by the boss that Dusk Bears Boots has actually won the bronze match 2-1.
So who were they playing up against again?
They were playing up against Team Nivius.
Yeah. Oh, and very nice bubble there. A lot of damage going on to NZ's stuff. Very good shield. Very good shield indeed. And quite a bit of damage going on that top line onto that top turret. It may go down before Renekton gets back there.
I think it will. The creep wave is absolutely gigantic. And Vi and Shin are actually trying to taunt them away from the turret, letting the minions do their work. So,
yeah,
nice
and
work.
It looks like it is going to go down. They may just... Oh, no. They seem to be backing off.
So that's good for Wurms, though. Like, successfully keeping it alive is always nice.
Yeah, definitely. But at the same time, you probably don't want it going fully down as Shin yet. You want to be able to, you know, farm without getting pushed or without overextending too far into that lane and leaving yourself open to J4 and mid-ganks. So he's probably quite happy just to get it down, you know, low, so he can take it when he wants, but he doesn't have to deal with that too far.
Yeah. So, the lanes are pretty static at the moment. I'm probably going to wait for the junglers to arrive before they do anything, really, I think. Although they have a little bit of kill potential on one another without him.
Yeah.
And they're probably waiting for both Kalthus and Shen to hit level 6. Kalthus just did.
Oh, Nami has been landing these bubbles quite consistently.
That's good, man. Really good.
Ooh, and a tower hit here, and here comes Vi. Here comes the ult as well. This could be dangerous, but they're not going to be able to catch up to them.
Nope. Nami gets away. Is forced to use Flash, and that's on a big cooldown, but that's okay. She's probably quite heavy to the life.
But Wobble's doing a really good job of keeping presence in all the lanes. Well, she hasn't. He hasn't got to mid yet, but really made an impact on top and bottom.
Yeah, so Jarvan and Renekton probably going to get a decent amount of damage on this turret. Maybe as much as Shen and Vi did to their own turret. There is another way of coming. They could probably get it if they really wanted it.
Yeah, definitely. They should be able to shut this down if that's what they want to do. If they want to open up that lane for ganks, which would be a good idea to shut down that Shen.
Yep, and they did pick that turret up. So nice pick up there.
Very nice pick indeed, and that's just going to open up that lane. And Vi just getting a bit of assistance on that red from Carlos. And so the balance as it sits now is 1-0 in turrets, 2 chow, and 0-1 in kills. So still pretty even. The gold, there's only a 400 gold difference, and it's actually sitting towards chow.
Yeah, it is. So they're CSing very well at the moment. The biggest advantage, I think, and let me just double check, Actually, you know, it's not a big advantage on any single person. It's more like they all have a slight CS lead. Which makes sense.
Yeah. The kind of 48 CS to the 59 on the Caitlyn is actually in the opposite direction to the overall gold advantage.
That's true.
Which is now tightened up to 300 gold.
Incredibly hard lane though for Tristana. Caitlyn has 100 range on Trist, so she's always going to be able to do a lot of work there, and it's hard. Once Trist hits level 13, she has the same range as Caitlyn, however, so that's always something to look out for. And at level 18, she outranges Caitlyn herself, so.
Yeah. It is a very, very interesting set of mechanics where that range does change over time. It really changes that dynamic in the lane.
Oh wow, we're seeing an amazing assault and battery into Stan United, and it looks like they're going to tower dive, try and get away from this Shen. And Jarvan has a right, and he might actually try and make something happen. Captain Wobbles on Vi is very, very weak. They might be able to catch up Vault support here. Wow, he's actually going for Wobbles.
Very nice cataclysm. Great shield.
On Wobbles.
Very nice bubble, and that's Wobbles down.
So that was a 1-0 in favor of Team Chao, and they turned around a really bad situation.
Yeah, it was a really nice slow there. You could see them all jumping in, but walking so slowly towards the Tristana, and they just couldn't close the gap. And that allowed Team Chao to react, and now they're actually going to get Dragon as well, it looks like.
It does look like it. They're doing a lot of work on it. However, everyone's trying to pressure.
And everybody's getting super low.
Arkhale's trying to die in his Dragon bit. It's going to be able to get his Requiem off. Right now, I think. And wow, this could be...
Boom, that's
nothing,
huge.
In fact. A lot of damage, but no short kills, apart from the Renekton.
Yeah, I thought it was going to be a lot bigger.
Big something. Yeah.
Unfortunate.
And they're all trying to cut away as Shen is coming in. Shen's going to be able to get a taunt off. Let's see what
who's he going to go for? But if he missteps, he could just get absolutely shredded with those four champs still being there. But it looks like they're just going to pick up the spot turret.
So that was 1-2 in favor of Team Chao. They got a dragon as well, but they're going to lose at least one turret, I think, off this. Vi is also pressuring down the mid turret, so there's going to be some damage there. And turret and minions have just arrived, which means they have a big tank to take away these turrets. So bot's definitely going to go down, and top is going to go down as well, and maybe even mid to this Vi. So we might see three turrets picked up for Team VGR. That's the second one, and it's just all about this Vi on the middle one, and it looks like she isn't going to be successful in getting it. But two turrets is still a lot of work done.
Yeah, no, that's definitely good, and we see the gold just tied up so closely at very nice lay wastes here. Renekton's doing his best to juke and keep him there for as long as possible, but he does get him down eventually.
Yeah, but very nice play.
Very nice play indeed. And Vi's caught the Orianna, but that slow down, speed up. Very effective and lovely dive here under a turret, and boom, Inzit stealth just goes straight down. Nice long range whirlwind, but it doesn't really have any effect. And this might be the spot turret gone. All three of these members are putting out a good amount of damage on this turret. And yep, that spot turret gone. So the turret count is evening up, and this is going to push Chao 200 gold ahead.
Yeah, it is. Alright, and my co-caster has to go to his Father's Day dinner, so I will be saying goodbye to OCG Pirate now, and continuing my solo cast until I can find someone else.
Definitely. It's been great to be on stream, but you have to duck out, because it looks like it's going to be a very close game, and it may actually go to 5 games.
It may indeed. Alright man, so have a good dinner, and have a good Father's Day, and I will talk to you later.
Great man. See you later.
Alright. So we're back into it. Renekton is pushing up this top wave. Shen is here to look after him, however, and push the wave back. Shen hasn't completed his Sunfire Cape just yet, so his damage isn't really there. And as I say that, he's actually outbullying Renekton quite considerably, which is really surprising, but Shen has been doing this all day from what we've seen. and it looks like the three members of Team Chow have actually rotated mid, trying to get some damage onto this middle turret. But this could be really bad. Another Stan United slash wall breaking combo coming out, and it's gonna be Tristan pulling it straight away. Barry is good as she rocket jumped out, getting some nice damage down, but VJR coming in so strong. Huge shockwave coming out from the Orianna. So much damage going down. Shin dies to the ignite. Karthus dies to the Nami, and Vi picks up the protection while it's still going on. Huge Requiem comes down, but isn't gonna pick up anyone else, and that was a 1v2 in favor of Team Chow. And again, they turn another team fight because of that amazing AoE from this Orianna. Orianna being a scary quirk. So this mid turret has gone down for Team Chow, and that's kind of unfortunate because they lose so much map presence when that initial turret does go down. It denies them vision and it denies them control, and they'll really be looking to take back Team VGR's first mid turret to, you know, answer back in kind and equalize the map. Otherwise the score is 3-2 in turrets, 5-4 in kills in favor of Team Chow, and the gold is slightly in the favor of Team Chow as well. Only 500 gold, which is not a lot at this stage in time, but, you know, still an amount we can talk about. So it's good to know, but it's not game-changing, as, you know, 500 gold over 5 members really isn't enough to build an item that creates an advantage. Wongsa on Renekton has been having a really rough game, 0-4. He's actually got all the deaths for his team, but he's been playing like Reginald does from TSM. He dives in there, he gets dirty, he gets messy, he doesn't really care about his KDA as long as he's doing his job, and he has been doing his job. So big props to him for not worrying what the scoreboard is and playing like you should on Renekton. And he's already finished that Sunfire Cape, hasn't tanked up too much just yet, hasn't even got his boots yet, but he's in a really good place item-wise. And it looks like they're grouping mid, trying to make another play again. Vi's ultimate is back up, but Requiem and Stan United is not. And it looks like Vi might be coming over the wall. And she does fire that Assault Battery. Picks up both Lime and Renekton in the knockout. Catapult does come down. Shockwave comes out as well. Huge amount of damage. Nami Wave knocks up all three as well. We actually see SM Limes go down to end this stealth. And it looks like the team fight is in VGR's favor. Tristana has a rifle from the side going in, assassinating the Karthus and bringing him down. Requiem is not up, and Wongsa on Renekton has come back in, actually picks up a kill on Shen, but I think Vi and the rest of the members of Team VGR are going to pick that up as well. So that was 2-2. Based on the members that died, I'd say that's very even. That was mid laner and top laner that died for VGR, but top laner and jungler that died for Team Chow. And it looks like Caitlyn's getting some nice damage onto this turret, but isn't going to be able to take it away. And Tristana is here to defend it, and has finished a Blade of the Rune King, so Caitlyn has to worry a little bit about that. It looks like Team Chow are pushing up this mid lane again, getting some nice damage down on the creep wave, so it's going to be there quickly. I think they're going to be able to get some nice damage on the turret before the rest of VGR arrives. And they are diving under the turret. The bolt is good, Stan United does come out. Arcanine taking quite a bit of damage. Froggy is only just trade the aggro, and it looks like everyone's going to be able to peel away. Requiem is up for when Karthus does die, but he's probably not going to look... Wow! Shockwave comes out a little bit late, and RKL has to go back. He's going to teleport away, but he does have a summoner teleport to come back into the fray if something happens. The siege continues on this mid turret, and it looks like Tristana is getting some really nice damage off. Fire is coming again, taking a lot of damage. Her bolt breaker is not up just yet. Karthus is actually teleporting behind everyone. They pick up the first kill of the match. Shen does spawn Tristana and is pushing him away. Tristana has to find a proper target to fight. She has a nice buster shot off, but does go down to lay waste from Karthus. And that is 2-0 in favor of VGR at the moment, and they are only continuing their rampage. And it looks like the other three members of Team Chow are gonna go back in and try and make something happen. Wongsa does go down to Vi with the Ace in the Hole resetting, and it is back up. So you need to be very wary about that. Does come out, isn't enough damage to pick up this Orianna. Requiem, however, probably is going to be, and Requiem does pick up Orianna. Nice combo. That's almost like a semi-global ability, and they're gonna be pretty happy about that. An RKL on Karthus is now pushing down this top turret. Looks like it's probably gonna go down in the next wave or so, but Tristana arrives. Nice timing right from Tris. Looks like she's actually chasing. Trying to make something happen. She flashes in, uses a blade of the Rune King, gets the explosive shot off, gets the buster shot off, and that is one dead Karthus. So nice pickup there, picking up a blue buff for herself, some extra gold as well. Meanwhile, VGR do pick up the dragon. So they're gonna be pretty happy with themselves. They did create a lead. They won their first team fight. They won it pretty convincingly as well. The globals didn't matter so much because all five members were there, but you will begin to feel their presence again as soon as Jhin starts split pushing. Janna trying to steal away this red buff. It'll be interesting to see if she can get it. This mid turret hasn't died yet. Team Chao probably pretty sour about that. It really needs to go down to open up this mid lane because they keep coming back trying to get it. So, Pro E on Tristana did manage to get the red buff. Wolf is going to be unhappy about that. He was throwing it out for someone of his own team to get it. Unfortunately, it didn't happen. Things are going down on their own red buff. They're probably going to give that to NZ Stealth on Caitlyn. But otherwise, very good. Very standard. Both teams getting their own red buffs, which is what you always want. Shen has now started his split push finally. Stand United isn't up just yet. 5 seconds until it is, but that's alright because, you know, he's already there. He's already up and all that good stuff. So he'll start the split push. I wouldn't be surprised to see the four members of Team GGR group up now and try and make something happen, as they do have the split push pressure as well as the global ultimate pressure. And that's pretty much the way you play with Shen. It'd be easier if they push bottom turret, because Shin is so much further away and do so much more damage if they decide to bug out. But it looks like they are pushing down in the mid wave. It looks like they're gonna gift Karthus a blue buff instead of continuing the siege. Shin's actually just standing around waiting for the wave to be pushed back up. He doesn't want to overextend while his team isn't there, which is a pretty wise move, all things considered. And they've grouped back up after the blue buff and the red buff have been picked up, and they're heading back down the midwave. It looks like they're all really keen to go into the jungle and just pick up some extra CS, but they really need to group now four objectives and try and make something happen. Shen has started the split push again, and Renekton has gone to meet him. Renekton just picked up a Negatron cloak, so maybe Shen's damage is going to be a little bit lower, and it looks like Renekton can indeed kill him. Shen United does come out though, and there's a team fight in the mid lane. Karthus is already going in, Ignite went down on Tristana, trying to land more of his late waves. Orianna completely misses the shockwave, unfortunately. Jarvan forced to run away from the side. Caitlyn does have her, and does pick up the Jarvan with the ace in the hole. Riflame comes out as well. Everyone running around very slowly, as Karthus does have that Rylai's Crystal Scepter. And Team VGR pick up 1-0, push everyone out of the lane, and start the siege on this mid turret successfully. And they're looking very strong at the moment. Definitely controlling the pace of the map. They are in the driver's seat. Looking very good. Ball has been put on top of Renekton's head, and he does go and clear the creep wave. And VGR are pulling out at the moment. Looking probably to go back and cash in all the money that is made. They're all sitting on over 1,000 gold apart from Vi. And they'll be able to buy a nice item, or complete an item, and make the advantage they just got more apparent. Tristana trying to 1v1 the Karthus again, walks over the Wall of Pain however, and gets slowed down instantly. So, Tristana's picked up her first core item in Blade of the Rune King, and is aiming for that Infinity Edge as the second item. Caitlyn's already finished Infinity Edge and Azeal, so it's in a good place item-wise. Tristana's actually the best score on her team, 4-1-2, really nice CS as well, at 154. So we'll be looking to be the hyper carry for her team. And this first turret does go down, finally getting that one. Lime does go on Demacia's standard dragons by combo, but no one was there to knock up, so he's just gonna peel away now. There's also no oracles for Team VGR. They do have pink wards, but that's not the same as a walking oracles. They'll be able to make things happen, especially if they don't know they're there. They're actually sitting up with Death Bush at the moment, so it'll be really interesting to see if anything happens. Lambs does go in with his Cataclysm, and wow,
I'm just gonna check, but I think the Shockwave missed again. Shockwave did miss again. Our Valor's just teleported in. It's walking us up with everyone. Ace in the Hole comes out again and picks up life. Ender's Death is now cutting away from Wongsa. Wongsa's trying to get on double with, but he's walking over to Vile, so he was slowed. From there, Twilight's just receptor. Nice bubble comes out to pick up Ender's Death. And now the members of VGR are just chasing down members of Team Chao. And Team Chao lost another team fight, unfortunately. This is the first time they've tried to initiate in quite a while. It just didn't work out for them. Tristana is looking for Volt support in the bot lane. But Volt has already pulled away, so Pro E is going to be able to pick up the Street Wave. Wobbles and NZ Stealth finally did pick up that Orianna, who's been running around for quite a while now. And a very convincing teamfight win for VGR. So the map has reset a little bit. Everyone's going back to clear their creep waves and jungle camps. And we'll be looking to pick up maybe this next dragon. They're all congregating here, they probably have the timer. It's probably up in a couple of seconds, and that's what they're all waiting for. Karthus, on the other hand, has just gone bot to pick up a huge creep wave. Karthus is very creep-hungry champion. It's pretty much how you play him. He requires all those core items, core components. He's got the Rylas Crystal Scepter, he's got a tier, and it's very well stacked. He's probably going to be picking up Rabidons as his next item, and then Archangel Staff, which will pretty much instantly turn into a Seraph's Embrace. And we're looking at very high AP Karthus. Only at 249 at the moment compared to Orianna's 192. Orianna has opted for the Athene's Unholy Grail first item, which is helping her against the Karthus, but not so much against anyone else on the team. And Karthus has picked up the Rabidons, bringing his ability power up to 324. So he's looking very strong at the moment. He's actually opted for Homeguard Boots, which I guess makes sense with his teleport. So he can come in with that speed boost and make things happen. Caitlyn's still running around clearing creep waves. She's probably going to go back at some point and finish that Infinity Edge. She is sitting on 1800 gold, which is enough to buy it, so I'm surprised she hasn't gone back just then. A couple of members of Team Chao are coming top to try push this Shen back. Lots of pings going down saying, I'm coming. And maybe they wanted to collapse on them and make something happen. It looks like they might even force a Baron fight. They definitely have the team for it. Shen can tank it very easily. Karthus does a lot of single target damage with that Lay Waste. Wow, Voltbreaker does come out on the Orianna. Getting some nice damage down. Ace in the Hole comes out as well. Renekton almost gets there to stop it. Does, however, break Vise, Assault, and Battery. Voltbreaker. Stopping him from getting in. Renekton now running away furiously. Has to pop his ultimate. Gives him some extra sustain. Try to make it away. Nice Shockwave coming out. Three members of Team VGR. But that was a successful 1-0 trade in favor of Team VGR. And it looks like they might Baron now. Volp is probably going... Shen is actually going back. I should take that back. Has picked up a Sunfire Cape. Has almost finished his Warmogs as well. Lots of pings going down. The team has tried to stop Baron again, but it's going to be very hard to do. Volt has picked up an Oracle, so it was sorely needed. It'll help them keep the Baron in their court as well. And everyone's recalling now. Probably going to come back and do exactly the same thing again. VGR are so far ahead that they can force objectives like this, so it's a good place to be. Item and Global Wise. The Caitlyn opted to pick up a Last Whisper instead of finishing a Phantom Dancer. That makes a lot of sense, just considering that both Jarvan and Renekton have built a lot of armor. Sunfire Cape and Ninja Tabi and Aegis and Elder Lizard, they're all items that give you a lot of HP and some armor, so getting that Last Whisper will mean that she can shred straight through that, as well as shred the targets she was already destroying, as that penetration does help against, you know, base statistics. So good pickup from itself to get that early. She may feel that she doesn't actually need that extra attack speed. She would much prefer more damage and a lot more armor penetration. Ping's going down again. It looks like they're probably going to put some wards down, just so they're sure of what's happening. It was actually a pink ward. Captain Wobbles is running on with two pink wards, which is very nice of him, all things considered. But they're very aggressively warding up the enemy jungle, trying to make something happen, trying to deny vision, and just be very intimidating. We've actually got two members, both members with Global Ultimates in this bottom lane, Shen and Karthus. The other three members of VGR are mid lane. So Renekton is being sent to try to deal with Shen and Karthus. I'm not sure if they're going to do it 1v2. And the other four members of Team Chao are mid lane, trying to answer to the three that's there. The turret does go down to Karthus and Shen. This is an effective way of split pushing I hadn't really thought about. Both missed the taunt onto Nami. Nami very lucky, she would have gone down to Karthus' damage if she got taunted. Ariana getting some nice poke up over the wall, unfortunately misses the second part of it as people had already moved away. Karthus is split pushing again in the bot lane. Shen actually recoiled to pick up his Warmogs and hit the top lane. This is absolutely fine because he still does have that stand united. However, VGR are splitting quite a lot at the moment, all things considered. And that probably means that they're looking to maybe pressure Baron or get their own jungle or something like that in the interim. They're having a hard time sieging the base of Team Chao, and that's understandable. Caitlyn's very good at sieging turrets, but she hasn't been able to go up and siege those turrets for fear of Nami bubble and other things like that. And just waves being cleared at the moment. Nothing too big to speak about. Red buff did just spawn, however, for Team Chao, and it looks like that is going to be gifted to Tristana. However, they know exactly where they are. They could either go try and stop them, or do what they're doing, which is push down the mid lane. Unfortunately, the creep wave has been denied. Quite good wave clear coming up from the members of Team Chao, so they're not going to be able to make anything happen. Shen is split pushing top again with Stan United. Very tanky Shen at the moment. 3,600 HP. Big Warmogs. It's going to hurt.
Blue team's turret has been destroyed.
And Shen secures another turret, bringing the turret count to 6-3 in favor of VGR, and the gold gap only widening. I wouldn't be surprised if they back off and steal this blue buff, and maybe even try for Baron. It'd be interesting to see who this blue buff does go to, and it looks like it's going to go to the Caitlyn, which makes sense. She can use that cooldown reduction, and it looks like they're going to start baiting Baron behind the wall again. Team Chao are heading there. Lots of pings going down. It looks like Bai is going to try to do a vault breaker over the wall, maybe with Shen coming on over the top. The teleport is going down to Karthus. He has home guarded out. Stan United comes straight down onto him. Karthus takes so much damage though. Actually gets buster shotted out and dies. Out of range of his smile. Red Claim comes straight down. Shut down on the Bai as well. Two kills picked up from Karthus with that Red Claim. Worms are doing some serious work. Tristana though, actually turning the face of this fight. Jumping on top of all the members of Team VGR. Worms goes back in and gets some really nice damage off. Shen manages to trade one for one. Nice Monsoon coming up from Janna, pushing everyone away and resetting the fight. But that was 3-4. And if Nami finds this Janna, it's going to be 3-5. Nice slow coming out from the Nami. Misses the bubble though, and pings are going to back up. Karthus has hit at bottom. I think VGR are probably a little bit surprised they lost that teamfight so badly. Tristana sitting on 7-1-4. 43 core components and is heading towards either a Quicksilver Sash or a Guardian Angel based on that Negatron cloak. So the Tristana doing some serious work in that last teamfight. Props to a team for doing so well as well. Wongsa on Renekton, 2-9, but that just doesn't matter. He's doing his job expertly. He's now picked up a Spirit Passage and a Warden's Mail. So he has some really, really decent resistances. And that's probably enough to keep him there. His base statistics in terms of damage is really up there. So he's not worrying too much about doing the damage. He just wants to tank it and survive it.
And he's had a great job at that so far. So yeah, very surprising that they did win that last team fight, but VGR have regrouped, and let's see if they can do it again. If they lose another team fight, I'd probably say Team Chao is going to take this away. They need to get rid of the Tristana. They need that to be the focus of all their attentions. Otherwise, they will lose. You can't leave a hyper carry like that sitting in the back destroying your team. Pro E on Tristana just went in and pretty much blew up the Caitlyn as well. Which is surprising considering Inter Stealth has been doing so well so far. But having a hard time dealing with that Tristana in a 1v1 scenario considering the items she has. And Team Chao running straight up the mid lane, playing very aggressively now, pushing the small advantage they did get off that last Baron fight. So wards going over everywhere, they don't know where the Vi is. Stand United is up, they're probably going to do another Stand United Vi play. Pings are going down, they know the Vi is there. They might actually try making a play on the Vi. Dragon Strike actually misses the Jarvan, so he's definitely going to come down. Wow! The Tristana is out of position though. Stand United does come down, gets the clone onto the Tristana. Tristana barrier is there, but she's melting through this Vi. Vi's Vault Breaker was stopped. Shen might have to flash over the wall as well. Meanwhile, Team Chao lose two of their members to the other members of Team VGR. So, Inter Stealth sitting on a red buff, just doing some serious work while the Karthus and the Janna help him out. So it was a 2-0 in favor of Team VGR, that's exactly what they wanted. And they're pushing down the mid wave, aiming for this turret. And Inter Stealth has connected with the turret, getting some really, really sick damage off. The base ratios are ridiculous. One turret away, one hit away from getting that turret, but they actually back off. Karthus has gone bot again, getting more of that farm, has tunnel visioned on that. And the game is looking pretty even at the moment. It's going to be really based around the next big team fight, as we did see VGR just won that one. But Team Chao won the team fight previous to that. So it'll be interesting to see what happens. So the red buff is up. I wouldn't be surprised if they give that straight to Tristana, who's sitting on some really nice items. Yes, this is the best of five. We're actually in game four. The score is 2-1 in favor of Team VGR. So if they win this one, they win this grand finals. If they lose this, we're going to go to a best the game five of the best of five. And Wong Zi on Renekton keeps picking up Caitlyn traps. Vi uses a Vault Breaker to go up the wall, and it looks like they're going to reset. They've got a double split push happening in the moment. Karthus in the bot lane, Shen in the top lane. It looks like they're going to do the Shen combo again. Karthus is teleporting in. They go and do so much damage. It's Orianna has to focus on all their work. Taunt goes on to the Orianna as well. Nice Nami wave disengaging. Shockwave comes out as well. They use the Orianna shield and heal. The Orianna's actually going to survive. Again though, both the other members of Team Chao are going to go down. The huge weapon comes out, and the shutdown onto the Tristana as well. And I feel like VGR are going to be able to push very hard off the back of this. The Orianna got out was absolutely amazing. Nice shield coming out from her, nice heal coming out from the Nami. Very hard. And strangely enough, they are going for the Baron as well as that first turret. So it looks like they're prioritizing the Baron over getting the inhibitor. So it may be that they feel like they're going to win the next team fight very easily if they have the Baron buff, or they want that objective off the map. It's always worrying. Now they're all recalling, and they're sitting on quite a considerable amount of gold, considering they won that last team fight. Caitlyn's actually gone back, and I think she's going to be able to finish a Bloodthirster, if I'm not mistaken. So let me just check what she spends her money on. Oh, she hasn't actually recalled. I was wondering why she hasn't bought it yet. However, one more script slash sunfire hit has been finished on Shen. That's absolutely huge. He also has an Oracles. Janna is sitting on a Shirelia's, as well as her Ionian Boots of Lucidity and Ruby Sidestone. Karthus is sitting on 772 ability buff, which is just ridiculous when it really comes down to it, as Requiems are going to be doing 900 damage, almost 1000 damage before resistances are taken into account. And he does have a little bit of spell penetration with those Sorcerer's Shoes. He'll get more when if he finishes the Void Stomp or anything like that, but it looks like he's actually going Spell Vamp instead. And they're picking up a dragon as well. Just removing all the objectives off the map in terms of buffs. So there's nothing left for Team Chao to come back with. So Shen is still pushing top against Sand United. This is a very similar trend. Karthus was bot, but he doesn't actually have teleport at the moment, so he's gonna head back to mid lane with the rest of his team. It looks like this open inhibit is the next point or goal for the team. Renekton coming in hot with his home guard boots. Looks like he's getting a Renekton's Omen next item. So very tanky items. Everyone's backing off actually. I think they thought that the blue buff was up. Fly came over the wall with Godbreaker, looking to pick that one up, but it was not. And the open inhibitor is now a point of focus for Team VGR. Team Chao really need to defend this. They need to keep the game going later and later so that the Orianna gets more ability power. The Tristana hits another core item. She's actually sitting at 4 items now. If you discount her Berserker Screams, and I do. Whereas Caitlyn is sitting at 4.5, as she has a Zeal that's not yet finished with setting 2. Wow, huge amount of damage coming out from Karthus, picking up the Orianna. And Rampage goes to instant step as he does crit his way through that Jarvan. Pro-E gets crit as well as he jumps away. There's 3 members of Team Chao going down, and it looks like this might actually be the GG. It looks like VGR are going to win this Grand Finals. Spy comes in as well, and the Nexus turrets are being sieged down. And it looks like they are going to go down very quickly. Renekton comes in with absolutely a lot of damage, but it isn't enough. Baron buff regen and resistance the team have. And the Nexus is going down. So good game, well played to Team VGR. Alright guys, that was the last game of the night. VGR did win the set 3-1. Das Bears, let me get the name proper for you guys. Das Bear Boots won the bronze match, coming third. And of course, we've got Team. Oh my god, my mind is completely disappeared. Team Chao coming in second place. So, Team VGR are going to win the Oceanic Gaming sponsorship to go to Digital Nations League of Legends tournament. Team Chao are going to win $100 cash, and third place is going to win $50 cash. So, nice prizes for the teams to play a weekend tournament. Congrats to everyone that was involved. You all played majestically. It was beautiful. I cried. I really did. I swear. But yeah, great tournament. All the videos will be available on our YouTube, which is youtube.com/OceanicGamingNet. If you are interested in checking them out, we'll also be posting about them on Facebook. The first place prize for this tournament, the sponsorship, was the 5 tickets to the tournament, custom team shirts with the team logo, team name, and the player name, as well as the Oceanic Gaming logo. They'll be featured on our webpage and featured in the exhibition matches, and we may be looking for sponsorship opportunities beyond just this next tournament. So with that, and without further ado guys, I will be signing off for the night. Thank you so much for being involved, and thanks for playing, and we'll be getting in contact with all of the winners in the fullness of time regarding their prizing. So I hope you guys enjoyed it. The VODs will be up. I know everyone was busy today with the NA LCS playoffs. Unfortunately, this is the only time we can run it, as it is a weekend, and this is the most free time most of us have working full-time. So we will see you all next Thursday for...